Future Trend Channel is glad to welcome all of our subscribers, and for the date of 19 of October 2018, we start our everyday's analysis of how to trade not only major currencies or commodity block of currencies, but some other currency pairs. And today we'd like to concentrate your attention around the euro crosses. As you could see, and it's not a secret, the euro currency is under increasing selling pressure right now. That's because of growing European Union's Commission's criticism regarding rising budget deficit in Italy, a populist budget deficit. And of course, as this situation will continue, and the tensions between Italy and European Union itself will rise, of course. In that case, the euro currency should remain under the downside pressure in the nearest future. Our point of view that the situation is not so dramatic right now. We suggest that sooner or later the situation will come down, and the euro currency will be back to the strength. But of course, not only from fundamental point of view, but also from the point of view of technical speaking, the euro currency at the moment is not looking so well, is not looking so strong. And today we'd like once again we'd like to emphasize that we'd like to concentrate your attention around the euro currencies, around the euro crosses. And first of all, that's because for a long period of time we haven't discussed such kind of currencies. Usually, as you know, we are speaking about the major currencies. And today, besides of the fundamental point of view, let's see how the euro currencies could evolve in the foreseeable future from a technical point of view. Probably right now it's a kind of correct answer to the question, because the situation from the economic reason is not looking so stable right now. That's why today we'd like to note the technical aspects of trading at the euro currency, euro crosses right now. And as usually, we are starting from the euro yen. The euro yen that was plunged to the lows around 128.30 during yesterday's trading session. It's about 30 points from our entry level. As you know, we still consider to enter a new long position in the currency at the level of 128, with a very close stop loss around 127.70. Of course, from the point of view of trading in the really nearest future, the euro yen is still looking fragile. And probably it's not a good idea to enter fresh longs right now. Anyway, we'd like to say that first of all, 128 is a kind of interesting level to enter. But of course, from a longer term point of view, really interesting kind of level is located around 125. That's the level of longer term uptrend line in the currency, the uptrend line of 2016-2018. And while above this trend line, the euro yen should continue to look more or less bullish. And also, as you could see, around 125 formed a kind of double bottom in 2018. So from all kind of aspects, technical aspects, this kind of a level should present a formidable support. Of course, it's a little bit premature to speak about this level, because we are trading around 3.5, around 4 big levels, big figures from that level. Anyway, we should point out such kind of moments to you, because of course from a point of view of short-term speaking, right now the euro yen is looking bearish. As regarding some other currencies, euro sterling should remain under the pressure while trading first of all below moving average 200 daily line located at 0.8833 at the moment. Also, we're still trading below the 2018 downtrend line, the nearest a kind of short-term downtrend line located at 0.8880. That's why we still continue to suggest to keep our short trade recommendation initiated at 0.88. We are ready to add to existing position at 0.8850 with a stop above the aforementioned downtrend line. Of course, a lot of will depend here in the euro sterling will depend on continuous Brexit negotiations between European Union and UK, and of course the last portion of news we've got from the UK, where the Prime Minister Theresa May told that the last proposal from the side of European Union regarding the Irish border relations is not unacceptable for the UK side. Of course, it's not boding well for the sterling currency, and that's why the cable itself should remain under the pressure. And as you could see, the cable at the moment, let's see the chart, is really very close to test its rising uptrend line located around a pivotal support of 130. For those looking for trading opportunities, probably it's time to enter fresh long positions in the cable with a stop below aforementioned support level 130. But of course we should not underestimate the situation of Brexit negotiation process, and also don't forget that today is Friday, the closing of the week, and who knows what could happen during the weekend hours. And finally, we'd like to concentrate your attention around the Euro-Swiss currency, which is from one point of view continue to look more or less bold, more or less bullish, while trading above 113, where lies current uptrend line in the currency. But of course, from a longer term point of view, Euro-Swiss still trading below its moving average 200 daily line located at 115.91, and of course from that point of view the situation, a longer term situation, is not so stable, not so encouraging for fresh long position in the currency. Our idea is to trade the Euro Swiss from a long term, from a long side, from a longer positions, but we are ready to enter a new long position only in case of possible testing of the uptrend line located around 113 1310. Thank you very much, our dear subscribers, our dear readers. We will be back to you on next Monday, 22 of October. And we wish you a pleasant closing of the week, as well as a pleasant and nice weekend for all of you. Take care. Bye-bye for now.